Hi guys, this is Karthik. Welcome back to the channel. And I'll be solving the problem removing digits. So I recommend you to pause the video and try to solve it on your own first. And then we will move towards the problem statement explanation and the solution. So yeah, you're given an integer n and you can write the decimal representation of n. From the number n, you can take any digit that appears in n and subtract that digit from n, okay? And then doing this continuously, you would like to find out what is the minimum number of steps in which you can make n equal to 0. So let me show you a sample case. So for example, we have 27. I can either subtract 2 from this number or 7 because there are just 2 digits appearing here. So I can subtract either 2 from it or 7. If I subtract 2 from this number, I will get 25. If I subtract 7 from it, I will get 20. From 25, I can either subtract 2 or 5. So from here, you can see that I have this number 20. From this, I can only subtract 2 because subtracting 20 means that I'm using one step, but I'm not getting any advantage of that particular step, right? I want to have the minimum number of steps. So why will I perform a step that is useless, right? So I will not take 0 to be a step. I will just check what happens if I subtract 2 from this. Okay, I'll get 18. And this way I can keep trying. And they are saying that the shortest way, the minimum number of operations will be 5 to make 27 to 0. And they've shown that you can go from 27, you can subtract 7, it will go to 20. From here you can subtract 2 and reach 18. Then you can reach 10, subtract 1, reach 9, and subtract 9, reach 0. So this is okay. The 1 step, 2 step, 3 step, 4 step, and 5 steps. So hopefully the problem statement and the input output are clear and we'll be moving towards the solution now. So here is what we want to do. We have this particular number that is having the digits d1, d2, d3, so on till dn. Our integer consists of, let's say, some k number of digits, and there are d1, d2, d3, so on till dk. Now again, in one step, I could subtract any of the digits from the number. So I could subtract d1 or d2 or so on till dk. And this will be one step. Okay, in this first step, I'll be subtracting one of the digits from my number. And I will reach some new numbers, okay? Let's say I reach x1, x2, so on till xk. Here x1 equals to this particular number minus d1 and xk equals to this number minus dk. This is concatenation, okay? D1 concatenated d2. Basically, these are d1, d2, d3, so on till dk are digits. Single one integer between 0 to 9. Except for d1, which is always greater than 0. Now, given that I've performed one step two, and after one step, I can reach either x1 or x2 or so until xk. Since I am using one step, from x1, if I go this side in this direction, I go to x1 by subtracting d1. Then from x1, somehow I would like to reach 0. And this will take some number of steps to go from x1 to 0. Similarly, from x2 also, I want to reach 0. And there will be some number of steps that I need to take to reach to 0 from x2. So until from xk also I want to go to 0. And there will be some number of steps associated with xk. So that the minimum number of steps that I need to take so that I go from xk to 0. Okay. So let's say that the steps here to go from x1 to 0 are s1. To go from x2 to 0 are s2. And to go from xk to 0 are sk. Okay, so in one step, I could go to any of these numbers, right? And after that, reaching 0, I can, if I go to x1, I need s1 steps. If I go to x2, I need s2 steps. And so until if I go to xk, I need sk steps. So I'll be going to that particular guy from where it's the easiest to reach to 0. Or that means, in other words, I will go to that number from the initial number from the from here, I will go to that particular number so that 0 is closest to me. I need to perform the minimum number of operations to reach to 0. So I will go to x1, x2, or I will go to xi, so that si, the number of steps to go from xi to 0 is minimum among all these options. So with this idea, let's define our DP state. So let me define DP of I as the minimum number of steps we need to perform. Minimum steps needed to go from I to 0. Okay, this is my DP state. Then obviously my answer is going to be DP of n, right? Because we wanted to find what is the minimum number of steps needed to go from n to 0. So that's cool. Let's define our recurrence now. And once we have done that, we'll move to the code. So let's think about DP of n. First of all, I'm going to write n as some concatenation of some number of digits. So n is going to be some d1, d2, so on till some digits, okay? And I will try out subtracting each and every digit from n. And among all the different options that I can go to, I will choose the one which is the which from where it is the easiest to reach to 0. So let's say that in the number n, there appears a digit di. Then I can subtract di from n. If di appears in the decimal representation of n, I can subtract di from n, and that will be one step. And then from going from n minus di to 0, I will need exactly dp of n minus di steps by definition, okay? So this means if I subtract di from n, where di is a digit appearing in the decimal representation of n, then the number of steps, the minimum number of steps to reach n by subtracting di from n is equals to 1 plus dp of n minus di. The minimum steps, dp of n minus di represents the minimum steps needed to go from n minus di to 0. And among all the valid di's, so that di is greater than 0, I will be trying out all the possibilities. So, and among all these, I will choose whichever gives me the smaller number of steps. So minimum over all valid di are digits appearing in n. So guys, that's it. These are our recurrences. Finally, I can have dp of 0 equals to 0. You don't need to take any step to go from 0 to 0 because you're already there. So guys, that's it. Let's implement this now. So we've taken our integer. Let us declare a vector int dp. This will store what is the minimum steps to go from some number I to 0. I'll define dp of 0 to be 0 only. Let this be n plus 1. I will fill my dp table, and once that is done, my answer is going to be stored at dp of n. So I'll go from integer, I'll go calculating from I equal to 1 till n. And I will say, okay, try out every digit appearing in I. And how do I try out all the digits? Let me say temp equals to n. Now I will break temp one by one, getting each and every digit of temp. So while temp is not 0, integer di equals to temp modulo, this is the last digit of temp, and temp by equal to 10 will divide temporary by 10, and that digit will appear from temp. Okay, so we have this particular digit with me now. Among all the choices, I want to choose whichever is the smallest answer. So min steps needed, let me initialize this to some very large value. 1 is 6 plus 1 will be a huge enough value, right? My steps will always be less than this because my n is itself less than 10 power 6. So even if I'm subtracting a 1 at every step, I will still need at most 10 to the power 6 steps to reach 0. Yeah, so among these, my min steps will become 1 step from my number n, then 1 step for doing that plus dp of the minimum steps needed to go from n minus di to 0. The same recurrence we discussed. So that's it. Here I will say, okay, dp of I becomes main steps needed for this number. And guys, that's all. Let's try 27. Our answer should be 5. It's 2, it's incorrect. Let me check what's the problem. I'm going from I to N. Temporary becomes equal. Temporary has to be equal to I, right? Because I'm trying out all the possible numbers I can subtract from I. So I will check the decimal representation of I. It's still incorrect. Let me check why. So di becomes temp, well, temp not 0, and we have di equals to temporary mod this. Okay, let's just print this and it will be easy to debug. Okay, so there is some issue here. Everything is coming out to be 0 for some reason. Let me check. DP 0 equals to 0 is cool. Min steps, I'm having 1 plus DP of n minus DI. DI becomes the digits, so okay, this has to be I. I'm sorry, I have to subtract DI from the integer I, right? Sorry about this. It's still incorrect. So this does look correct to me now. Let me check. Alright, the main error that I'm making here is that I cannot subtract di from the number if di equals to 0. So if di itself is 0, then that would mean I don't really need to subtract it from it. And the error that it is going to produce is that in that particular case, I'm going to use an entry that was previously 0, right? DP of I itself was 0. And then it's going to use the result stored at DP of I, which is invalid currently, right? So I cannot subtract 0. So let me do this. If DI equals to 0, then just avoid going to that step, because you don't want to subtract 0 from I. You want to subtract at least a number that is equals to 1. So yeah, now I'm getting the correct answer. Let me try and submit. Also guys, there exists a greedy solution to this, which I did not discuss, because first of all, we will need to prove it. And then the idea here is that we want to learn dynamic programming. So even if there exists a greedy solution and dynamic programming is possible, it's better that you go for DP solution, because that is guaranteed to work. For greedy solutions, we will have to first prove the optimality and correctness. So it got an accepted. Hopefully guys, this was helpful to you. And do like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.